Greetings, one and all, from Kit Kat and me, but he's oof, bad position. There we go. Say hello, wave. there we go. Okay. Now you can sit there and park off. Right, so another Monday morning and the start to another, yet another artwork. And this time we're going to be doing a yet another forest scene and just a different kind of positioning or a viewpoint of a stand of pine trees. So here we go. Let me hit it. To get the ball rolling. Right, I've got the central, almost central piece. And let's just go off center a little bit. Yes, you can probably hear Kit Kat. He's lying just down here, purring like a diesel engine. Just setting up our composition here, slowly, with all these tall trees and whatnot. You're off, Kit Kat. Okay, bye. See ya. Okay, it's that one. that one. Okay. So, silence at the start, as usual. Now we've got this baby over here, and this one, as you'll see, will turn out to be our focal point. Ultimately, these clamps are right in the way. I'm gonna put them off to the edge if I can. And that one. Just to get them out of the way. Okay, out the way. Jesus. Seriously. Right. Let's take them both off at this point, because I want to work at the top and I don't want this interruption. No, that's better. I can work a little bit more freely now. Something a bit thicker than that now. All right. I just want to demarcate this one. You'll see why this becomes then our central focal point, or focal point area, in due course as the piece develops. I just want to set up these very basic areas of light and shade for the moment. Quite a dark piece in general. So that's going to be fairly extensive use of my compressed charcoal as well, and some nice dark shadows, and then my white and very pale yellows and what have you for very contrasting highlight areas. This piece may develop rapidly, it may not. It's the luck of the draw, who knows? Let's see what it requires. So very, very rough at this point as I set up the composition. Just trying to keep it as raw as possible, just to set up the very basics of light and shade. If I can possibly do that, because this thing's got a giant knot in it somewhere here. In fact, I want to use my, where is it? Here it is. Compressed charcoal right now. Get this part of the piece going. Just that I've got my very dark areas established. Yes, so we've got this very interesting, can I have this, end up with this very interesting balance of light and shade, and how it all kind of pulls together to form this real intrigue, if you will. Well, at least that's the plan. Might go completely different to that. But just establish some little spots of light over this side where the sky is showing a little bit through the upper reaches of the trees. And then the way these kind of vertical lines are stacked, also there's some discordant angles, so that we've got this kind of, they're almost almost as if they're balancing one against the other, like cards balanced up end on. And they're all kind of holding each other up, and that's kind of the idea for this, for the interest factor in this piece, that kind of that I find to be quite intriguing. And then over here we've got these branches which are reaching out. There's a, you can almost imagine there's a little pathway, a road or something like that, way down this side. On the very edges of the piece, or just outside of the aperture, and then these branches are now reaching out, stretching out over the roadway. You need to put these clamps back on again, I fear. just want to work down here a bit and get this bottom section sorted out. So once more, it's all about feeling. It's all about interpretation, interpreting the senses, what you might experience in this place. And I'm trying to, as I work, I'm trying to feel that. Kind of imagine this, almost this foreground area is strewn with pine needles that are spiky and sharp, and yet having fallen and are lying flat, provide a soft ground, perhaps littered with pine cones as well, to almost like little Lego pieces. And there's always a direction. There's always a direction to the, and that just happens because of where I'm positioned, and my wrist action is kind of that way. So the general flow is kind of there, almost an uphill scenario. I can build on that as well. And then, of course, above, you can, as I sit here, I can imagine the breeze high up above, whispering through the pine needles, hissing through the pine needles, I should say. It's more of that sort of sound always with pine. Pine trees, it's a different sound the leaves, the wind makes through the leaves. And these pine needles, they tend to hiss. So there's this hiss and a swish of sound. And then, of course, the Cape turtle doves. Way up high, never seem to see them, but there they are, always that sound. And then the smell, of course, that wonderful smell of pine cones, pine needles. This I need to put up here so I can work to the edge. I like to work to the edge. Yes, so there's that wonderful breezy kind of sense of freedom and bliss I always feel in when I'm in the forests like this. Especially when there's, you see, the kind of almost bare trunks, and then all the foliage is way up high, of course, catching the light up above. And then also providing a form of canopy, so there's cool dappled light down below, but in between there's this light showing through of the sky in the distance. It's a very serene kind of atmosphere, energy. And it always kind of takes me back to very vague, almost sort of ethereal childhood memories. Just a hint of a memory, not anything specific. It's just a feeling. The memory is just a feeling, an emotion, perhaps even, which is quite interesting, because that's kind of what I've been speaking about, that I like to be able to generate with my art in the viewer, you guys watching, is that I sit here and I interpret my feeling of this piece. I give it my energy, but then you, as the viewer, might pick up something completely different to what I'm feeling. You might have a different kind of awakening, or a light bulb moment, or just a hint of a memory as well. It might remind you perhaps of picnics or something like that, having picnics in the forest as a child, or something else, I don't know, but something completely different to what mine is, and yet it's only because you're picking up on the energy that I'm giving the piece, because that's what I'm here for, to do is just to provide the energy resource for this little scene here, and that's what gives this and any artwork soul, gives it its soul. I'm always on about that. Now, of course, I have my resident mosquito come to just remind me of its presence. That I should never be, I should be ever vigilant. And there was one that was troubling the hell out of me all night, just kept on flying at me. Bastards. You can't actually trap them. So there's the sense of down in the foreground here, on the floor of the forest, there's this more lateral flow versus this upper two-thirds of the piece, which is more vertical in its essence, except for on the side here and little odd pieces, but by and large, there's this almost like barcoded kind of essence up here, and then down below there's this lateral softness and gentleness and sumptuousness almost of the earth. Almost imagine sitting here and having spread your basutu blanket and sitting there with a with the wicker picnic hamper. Getting out the cups, the flasks, bread rolls, all that stuff, all that yummy stuff. And just kind of preparing for a lovely picnic in the woods. Just peace, tranquility, sound of birds. But always that overriding sound an intermittent sound of the Cape turtle dove. Wonderful, a wonderful sound. It always reminds me of woodlands. We don't get them here in Durban, but more inland, and certainly in more forested areas. Such a lovely sound. Perhaps they enjoy, or perhaps they even roost and make their nests in these kind of environments, for pine forests and also perhaps eucalyptus stands, forestation. This one. There's also a little bit of discord in terms of texture. The predominant feel is this heightened sense of heightened stretch, reach. Tomorrow, of course, I shall start adding colour to this piece. I have a sneaky feeling that this might be a two-session piece once again. I certainly want to start pulling in this sense of as we move into autumn here in the southern hemisphere, that sense of autumn colours, autumn vibes, fall, whatever you want to call it. What is the origins of the word fall? It's used, I suppose it's the falling leaves. That's where it perhaps was derived from. The season when leaves begin to fall. These kind of slightly streaky shadows sense of shadows, you get the sense of this uneven terrain. So that the cast shadows of these trees coming in from the side are not straight lines like these are. And I'm keeping this mostly fairly abstract in its interpretation. I don't want to get too literal. I'll get a little bit more literal on some of the bark of the trees here, just to kind of highlight that feeling of what the pine trees look like there, what their bark looks like, that sort of kind of gnarled but hairy graphic. Not smooth like the smooth white like the eucalyptus gum trees. Slightly different, a very different texture their bark has. Pine trees. So I'll hint at that as well. But by and large, this is more of an emotive piece than an accurate rendering. So you can start to build your interpretations and the metaphors to this. What is the meaning of it? What does it represent? I'll think about it too as I go, what it means to me, but just kind of the scene just really called itself into being. So I'm just working with my charcoal, a couple of different thicknesses, a little bit of compressed charcoal, and of course my white, Conte, and then white. Well, I haven't used my white pastel yet, but just working purely in black and white still at this stage. just scratchy lines, just building up a little bit of texture, just pulling together the various aspects of contrast. And once again, I shall be using my eraser quite extensively as well. Starting to balance. I think I shall use my white pastel now for a bit. Actually, you want to use a little stub so I can just put in some. Yeah, that's better. Susie. Eraser. Right. Yes, so just getting the basics going here, and it is coming along rather nicely. Quite enjoying this, actually. Yes, this definitely does have subtly more abstract qualities to it than the last one I did, just subtly. And I don't want to kind of, you know, get into the semantics of what is abstract and what isn't, but this is definitely more of a representation than realistic depiction. It's more setting the scene, setting the feelings. Than it is depicting the actual pine trees. I'm trying to convey the feeling of what pine trees are rather than their visual depiction. If you know what I'm saying. And that's what makes it fun for me. as I sit here helping this piece to come together, playing my role. It's interesting to have that sense of presence, like I'm just enjoying the surroundings rather than having the overriding responsibility of ensuring that this piece is a pretty picture or an accurate representation of pine trees and what have you. It's not, it's just, I'm just having fun and watching it come together as different tools and materials are called for to assist the coming together of this piece. Speaking in a kind of a roundabout way, because I am the artist and I am putting it together, but at the same time I'm not really focusing on that holding on to the end result idea. I have a small A5 sized reference drawing that I did yesterday, and I just sketched together in 10-15 minutes. It just gives the basic raw essence of it, and I really liked it. I really found it appealing, and I want to try and just capture that raw essence that I speak of. I want to try and keep the, because the small piece is very that's the word, I'm losing my mind here, is very graphic, very basic, and I find that particularly appealing, and I want to try and convey, even on a piece that's 8 times the size, I want to try and convey some of that raw essence. I think that I'm succeeding. At least I like to believe that I am. Just a few minutes left now. And I do believe that I have a nice strong strong basic essence for this piece. So that I can start building colour tomorrow during the next session. It's funny because I was actually lying there a little bit wakeful last night, and my mind was drifting over this piece, and I think it's going to be rather pleasant just to sit and perhaps contemplate. So tomorrow we shall be adding some browns and greens into this cool shady area, some yellows, almost lemon yellow, into these highlighted areas, quite intense as the late afternoon sun catches the mid to late afternoon sun catches these couple of tree trunks. Just if you can imagine that, this just through a gap, and this suddenly this one trunk lights up, along with a little glade of light here as well. So yeah, it's going to be fun. Anyway, right, I think I'm going to down tools for today. And love and leave you until tomorrow. So I do hope that you're enjoying the process as much as I have been so far. And yes, look forward to continuing tomorrow. Who knows, maybe even complete this piece. Yes, and I'll add some nice lilacs and blues to the sky-y areas. Yes, thanks for being present for me today. Thanks for joining me, and thank you for your comments and whatnot. And please feel free to ask any questions that you might have, or make any comment that you might seek to, and I'll be sure to respond. And I really appreciate it. Any new subscribers that come on board, awesome, thank you. Please like and share. I really appreciate that. And do tune in again on the morrow. So meantime, be good, be kind, be gentle, be caring, be loving. And oodles and oodles of toodles. See you again soon, guys, and take it easy. Have a fantastic day ahead. Bye then. Don't forget to doodle.